I recognize Senator Ted Ferrioli.
Mr. President, I'm going to depart a little bit from the usual, which would be to read the concurrent resolution. Members, each of you have the concurrent resolution, and I urge you to read it carefully. It's a great inspirational story of a lifetime of achievement. The family and Representative Jones will be given a copy of the resolution, of course. But I want to talk a little bit about the man that we're honoring today. Denny Jones was born the same day that the Pendleton Roundup was born in the state of Oregon, back in 1910. And at that time, colleagues, Oregon was still a relatively new idea. If you look at the date of Denny Jones' birth, you'd realize that state occurred merely 51 years prior to the arrival of Denny Jones. And, you know, it was into a family of pioneers that Denny Jones was born. In those days, the days of emigration, there were pioneers in many families in the state of Oregon. As a matter of fact, it was only 45 years after the Civil War had ended that Denny Jones became an Oregonian. He was born there in Ione. Henry Ford was trying to perfect the assembly method, the assembly line method of building automobiles, and the Wright brothers had flown the first heavier-than-air aircraft just 3 years before Denny himself touched down there in Ione. You know, that period of our history is just quite amazing. Denny was just 10 years old when the Roaring Twenties broke upon the state of Oregon, and that also was complete with flappers and bootleg rye and the Volstead Act, and we had our own crime wave in the form of the D'Otremont brothers, who blew up the Gold Flyer and the Siskiyou Pass in 1923. They killed four people and blew the train to smithereens and caused an international sensation as they escaped from their crime and spent quite a few years on the lam, as it were. The bottom of Wall Street dropped out in 1929. Denny was about 30 years, or in his late 20s, but Denny hardly noticed the bottom dropped out in Wall Street because he was too much engaged in the hard scrabble West, trying to make a living as a jockey, racing horses on the circuit between Canada and Mexico. He was also running cows and buckaroo-ing. He ran a four-horse team and a California wagon through the Sisters, through the town of Sisters, as such as it was, all through the Metolius Basin. Denny was buckarooing through the 1940s and 1950s around Gentura, cowboying and breaking horses and perfecting his craft as a cattleman. And there were few paved roads and no highways, virtually no highways in that country at the time. Denny and a partner made a deal to run a couple of ranches in that country, and they partnered for about a decade, eventually building up a pretty substantial herd. And when they sold out after 10 years of hard work, it netted Denny and his partner $50,000 each, which Denny turned into the Jonesboro Ranch, which has, had been a homestead that had been homesteaded in about 1872. Denny's been in the cattle business in one form or another all of his life. He came to the legislature in 1973 and served until term limits took him out in 1999. Denny's outlasted all of his political opponents and bested all of his critics, and he is still writing the Oregon story. When a man like Denny Jones calls you a friend, it doesn't matter how miserable a streak you're on, or how badly fortune treats you, or how low you're held in the esteem of the world. When Denny Jones calls you a friend, you can stand a little taller, square your shoulders, look life right in the eye, and just spit. Everyone who ever knew Denny Jones has a Denny Jones story. And they all start the same way, and they all end the same way. They start with somebody saying, "Denny Jones and me were on the breaks of the Snake River." Or, "Denny Jones and me were up in Canada." Or, "Denny Jones and me were down in Mexico racing horses." And they all end the same way, with an explosion of laughter and somebody else thinking up another story. I once asked Denny Jones, after a life of ranching, what he did with all of his money. He told me, "I spent most of it on whiskey and women, and the rest I just wasted." The greatest writer who has ever lived, William Shakespeare, wrote a mountain of words. And way up near the top of that mountain are the words, "To thine own self be true." We hear a lot about the Code of the West or the Cowboy Code. It's come to mean a lot of different things to different people. But it all boils down to this: loyalty and being true to your word. That's Denny Jones. If Denny'd been born in Australia, we'd be meeting in the Australian Parliament, talking about how Denny Jones pushed Brumbies across the outback. If Denny Jones had been born to a family of royals somewhere in Europe, why, when he got old enough to understand who they were, he'd have just wanted to have nothing to do with them. Because he's ours, and that's just the way she is. Thank you.